for the last several years, I've been promising my sons that we're going to get a dog. But the situation had to be right and the timing had to be right on it. So we finally got the prized possession, Stella.
It's been a lot of work having Stella, but it's really fun just to play with her and just see her run around. But it's a lot of responsibility, and I love the fact that she's always just wanting to play. She never just wants to lay down and do nothing and be lazy. She's always wanting to play.
What I really like about her is just, I really want her to be a good duck dog.
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah. I want her to be a good duck dog. That's a good job, Tuck.
Mossberg's Rugged American Hunter with Jason Cruz.
Today on Mossberg's Rugged American Hunter, I want to talk to you just for a second about traveling with a dog. If you have a hunting retriever, whether you hunt quail or pheasant, chucker, ducks, doves, geese, you're going to have to travel with your dog, and traveling with your dog is not easy. A few months ago, I ran into a friend of a friend that has become a good friend of mine, and I wanted him to be on the Mossberg Rugged American Hunter series because his story is so impressive. Addison Edmonds is the founder of Gunner Kennels. And what I love about the purity of his story is he was just a duck hunter who was frustrated with trying to find a kennel that he could put Gunner in. And he ended up creating one to meet his needs. And really the phenomenon started.
You know, I heard somewhere that frustration was the birthplace of most inventions. And I thought to myself, you know, that's probably true in my case. I've got a dog named Gunner, and I was very frustrated with the kennels that I was using to travel with him. I was frustrated because the kennel would slide around in the back of my truck. The little two-pin door system to open and close the door never worked. The dog would get out of the kennel when I didn't want him to. There was no designated place to put a strap to a kennel and strap it to the back of a truck. I'd shown up to a different hunts, and the dog kennel would be rolled over on the side with my dog looking at me like, dude, why'd you leave me in here? I thought that there had to have been a better way. Gunner's my best friend, and I just felt like I could do better than what he's got in terms of the kennel. I had no peace of mind when I was traveling around with him in a different crate. So I set my mind to it and designed a crate with him in mind. Here's why a good crate matters. For me, it's safety. When I was driving with Gunner in the back of my truck, number one, in a plastic crate, I was always worried about rolling over. Number two, if he wasn't in a crate, he was running around from side to side, and I was a distracted driver. If you were to get in a wreck, God forbid, and your dog is in a, say, wire or plastic crate, how's that crate gonna hold up in the wreck? I can tell you, it's not gonna hold up. We've done a lot of crash testing. We've reviewed a lot of other crash testing. The wire crates, the single wall plastic crates, they don't hold up. After many crash tests and further engineering, I finally felt like we had a crate that gives me the peace of mind for Gunner.
This is Stella. Stella hasn't gone to the retriever trainer yet. Stella came out of Punch's Click Click Boom and a dog named Cypress Knees Sadie and out of Mississippi, and Trigger's out of Alabama from Jack Pitts. And Stella is got a great bloodline. And when you got a dog that you really care about, you want a great kennel. And so I was looking for a kennel, and I ran into Addison. I just couldn't believe his story. So what's cool about this, Stella goes to the duck school, duck trainer, in a few weeks, actually. So we're gonna miss her, but she's gonna come back in great shape. This kennel, as you can tell, get in there, go. It has a paddle latch on it that is so secure. What I personally like as a duck hunter is securing my dog. And this kennel has a strap system that is truly second to none.
One of my biggest travel concerns was rollover. It happened to me a couple times with my other crates. So I designed stainless steel pins in the top four corners of the kennel so you know where to strap the kennel down from. Truthfully, one of the core reasons why this kennel is safer is because it's double-walled, rotationally molded. Think of a kayak that's roto-molded. What it boils down to is it's not brittle. So what that means is this kennel is engineered to take extreme punishment. I actually shot this kennel with a 12-gauge shotgun. Dropped it off a 200-foot cliff twice. To be honest, we don't know how much pressure it'll take to crush this kennel. We got an MGA research firm to independently test it, and it broke their machine at 4,000 pounds three different times. This started with me trying to take care of Gunner, my hunting buddy. But what it's grown into is all different walks of dog owners coming to us to protect their dog. And you know, it makes sense. It's pretty simple. Dog owners love their dogs.
A crate is a dog's home. One thing we did with Stella, if you're new to duck hunting or if you're new to hunting dogs, is make sure that you let that crate, make sure that you let that crate be a place of joy for them. It's not a cage. It's something that we keep Stella in. You don't want her eating stuff. You don't want her chewing stuff when she's a puppy that can hurt her. So you want to make sure that you keep your dog in a safe place. So really for her traveling in this, it's like traveling in her bedroom. Before we really got hardcore into dogs, I had a lot of waterfowl hunters tell me, travel with your dog as much as you can. And that is really true. It puts them in a different bunch of different contexts and a bunch of different situations. And I would encourage you to do that. It's really helped even Stella's young. I can tell she's acclimated to changing situations. Mossberg is spending a ton of time and energy creating content on YouTube and on their website and Twitter and Facebook for people that love to hunt, shoot, sporting events, sporting clays, tactics, you name it. We're building it. And we're building it to make the lifestyle that much easier to access and to have more fun in the field. If this video helped you, hey man, do us a favor, hit that like button on YouTube, but also, if you wouldn't mind, post it on your Facebook or any of your social media feeds, because I'm telling you, if it helped you, it's bound to help somebody else.